Generally, vacuum circuit breaker is used below 72.5 kV voltage level. In this video, you will learn about the parameters which are mentioned on a nameplate of vacuum circuit breaker. This is a nameplate of 36 kV VCB, so let's start. First is circuit breaker type. Few manufacturers also call this as a designation. This simply represents what manufacturer calls the product. In simple language, it is the name given by the manufacturer to the product. The next is serial number of the breaker. This has to be on the nameplate. Next is, as you can see, reference IS or IEC standard is mentioned. Basically, this tells us about the standard based on which the circuit breaker is manufactured. For this case, it is IS 13118 and IEC 56. This IEC 56 is now withdrawn and it is replaced by IEC 62271-100, which applies to the alternating current circuit breakers. Next is rated voltage, which is 36 kV in this case. Rated voltage is the highest system voltage for which breaker is designed. This voltage is mentioned in kV RMS or volt RMS, and it refers to the phase-to-phase voltage of three-phase system. Most of the time, people get confused between rated voltage and normal voltage. Rated voltage is the highest voltage of the system for which the system is designed. Whereas, normal voltage is the voltage which will remain in the system normally. So in this case, 36 kV is the rated voltage and 33 kV is its normal voltage. Similarly, for 245 kV voltage level, rated voltage is 245 kV and the normal voltage is 220 kV. Next is rated current. This is the rated current for which circuit breaker is designed. Circuit breaker is able to carry 1600 amp without any problem. Next is frequency. It is the power frequency on which electricity is generated, transmitted and distributed. In some countries it is 50 Hz and in some it is 60 Hz. Next is number of pole. This is equivalent to number of phases. On this nameplate it is mentioned as 3. So the breaker is 3 phase breakers, that is R, Y and B. You can ask, all the breakers must be 3 phase breakers by default. No, that's not the case. In few cases, single pole breaker or single phase breaker is also used. Also, in railway application, 2 pole or 2 phase breakers are used. Next is breaking capacity. It is the highest RMS value of short circuit current which circuit breaker is capable of breaking. Rated short circuit current, sometimes also called as symmetrical breaking current. This breaker is capable of breaking 25 kilo ampere. Next is making capacity. If the breaker closes during the existing fault condition, current may increase to a very high value during the first cycle, which means it remains in the system for a very short time. Therefore, the breaker must withstand this high current and the mechanical forces caused by this current. This current is called as short circuit making current, or it is also called as rated peak withstand current. It is generally 2.5 times the rated short circuit current at 50 Hz frequency. It referred in kilo ampere peak as it remains for a very short time. So if you multiply 2.5 with 25 kilo ampere, that will give us 62.5 kilo ampere as the making current. Next is short time current. Now this is the short time current of the system which may occur in case of fault, and this current may remain in the system for 3 seconds. As we have seen, our breaker is also capable of breaking 25 kilo ampere short circuit current. Next is DC component. Short circuit breaking current can be expressed in two values. One is the RMS value of AC component and another one is the DC component at the time of contact separation. On the nameplate, it is mentioned as 50%. Next is BIL or basic insulation levels. The first value, that is 70 kV, represents rated short duration power frequency withstand voltage. Power frequency withstand voltage can be caused by these reasons: phase to earth fault, load rejection, ferro resonance, Ferranti effect. And hence, breaker shall withstand power frequency voltage caused by these reasons. IEC has defined the level of power frequency voltage that can appear across the breaker contact. Circuit breaker has to undergo power frequency withstand test in which power frequency voltage is applied to circuit breaker for 1 minute. So this 70 kV represent that the breaker can withstand power frequency voltage of 70 kV. The next value is, that is 170 kV peak, represent rated lightning impulse withstand voltage. Lightning impulse voltage is generally generated due to the lightning strokes. And of course, breaker has to withstand these voltages too. Based on the experience and system studies, IEC has defined the values for this also. Breaker has to undergo test for this also. Please note, this value of insulation level is for altitude level less than or equal to 1000 meter above sea level. If the altitude level is more than 1000 meters, an altitude correction factor needs to be applied to this value. For instance, the values 70 kV and 170 kV peak are for altitude of 1000 meters. If the altitude level is, let's say, 1200 meters, then definitely these values will change. It will be more than the value specified on the nameplate shown. Next, you will see voltage rating of trip coil and closing coil is mentioned. The trip coil is also called a shunt trip coil. The voltage is generally DC voltage because the function of closing coil and tripping coil is very much important. And hence, it needs to have a steady and constant supply which can be provided by the battery banks. This voltage is also called as control voltage, as it is controlling the opening and closing operation of breaker. Generally, it is either 110 kV or 220 kV DC, at least in India. I'm not certain why both 110 and 220 kV DC is mentioned on this nameplate. It is very rare case where dual control voltage are provided. Next is operating sequence or duty. This is one of the important parameter of the breaker. It is also known as auto reclosing duty. Operating sequence denotes the opening and closing operation breaker is capable to perform under specified conditions. As per IEC 62271-1, there are two alternatives of operating sequences. One is OTCOT-CO, second is COT-CO. O is indicating the opening operation and C is indicating the closing operations. And all the T's are indicating time interval between the successive operations. Let me tell you how auto reclosing works. 90% of the faults on the system are transient in nature, which remains in the system for a very short time, and then the system goes back to normal. In such case, it is beneficial to put the system live again, and here the auto reclosing system comes into picture. We'll consider the auto reclosing duty, which is mentioned on our nameplate, that is O 0.3 seconds CO 3 minute CO. So let's say there is a fault on the system and hence the breaker will open. Then it will remain in open condition for 0.3 seconds. After 0.3 seconds, it will close again automatically, and if the fault is cleared, it will remain in closed condition. But if the fault is still there, then the breaker will open immediately. Now, breaker will remain in the open condition for 3 minutes. After 3 minutes, the breaker will close again, and if the fault is cleared, it will remain in closed condition. But if the fault is still there, then the breaker will open immediately again. And now, breaker will remain in open condition until it is closed manually. It is one of the very important features of circuit breaker. So we have covered all the parameters which are mentioned on the nameplate of vacuum circuit breaker. In case if you are interested in knowing the nameplate details of all the substation equipment, you can check out my playlist for that, link for which you will get in the description. And in case you are new on this channel, my name is Gaurav J. I post videos related to electrical engineering with easiest explanation. So if you are interested in electrical engineering, you can consider subscribing the channel. So if you found the video helpful and you got to know something new today, do like this video. That's all I ask. That's all for this video, guys. I'll see you in my next one. But till then, keep watching, keep learning.